You know that I'ma keep it cold. With you I feel like breaking rules. On the edge looking out with no parachute. You know I'm dreaming about us too. Playing around without a clue. On the edge leaning out. With us it's all or nothing.
Hey, what's going on YouTube? How are you? Today I want to be talking about my FPV journey 6 months in. I started flying FPV somewhere around really September through November, somewhere around there. And the reason why I mentioned such a large gap is because I purchased a drone in August of 2020 and then tried to fly it immediately and crashed. And that was the Bumblebee as I referenced before. So my first drone was the iFly Bumblebee. I practiced on liftoff, maybe like 5 flights. I thought I had the hang of it, went to the park and immediately broke a motor. So I'm sharing today my journey 6 months in because I feel like I've progressed tremendously. If you look at my videos when I first started, I was just doing straight lines and really didn't have any throttle control. So as I was flying, you saw my drone just float up and down, up and down, up and down. And then let's not even talk about my landings, because my landings were, I mean, I'm like 6 feet high and then I just kill the switch and the thing just drops. So that was quite a learning experience, was throttle control and landing. I noticed that a lot of people are getting the DJI FPV system. And you know, quite honestly, if you look online on the DJI forums or the Facebook groups, you see a lot of crashes already. I mean, people are destroying their drones. And you know, the experienced pilots, and even like people that I follow, like Original Dobo, Jay Rivera here locally, El Bujo, which is another FPV pilot here locally, they all say the same thing. You gotta respect this journey. You gotta respect the process. You just can't pick up an FPV quad and fly. I mean, I've made my mistakes, right? I've burned motors, I've broken arms, just trying to go up, but this is a different experience. It's totally different. So when I first started, I started with the DJI remote. The DJI remote and the DJI goggles, I went full digital, I didn't go analog. The digital is pretty cool because you see through your goggles, I'll throw some DVR footage now so you can see, but you see crystal clear. You know, analog, I think, is a good start as well. It's much cheaper. And I believe that if you start analog, you'll become a much better pilot when you transition over to digital, because analog, you're getting all that static, all that interference in your goggles, whereas digital, you're seeing crystal clear. So analog does make you a better pilot, in my opinion, when you start analog and transition over to digital. However, if you can just start digital, it's much easier. It's a much easier process. So these are the DJI goggles. Obviously, we've all seen them before. And one of the things that I did immediately after buying the DJI goggles is changed my foams here. It comes with a leather. It's better if you just switch it to foam. You get no light leaks through your side of your head. Then additionally, the strap. This is the iFlight strap. To me, I think you should get the fat straps, which is better. This is not tight enough for me, or it extends So I sometimes it slips down my head. Another nice cool upgrade that you should definitely do is, well, if you're flying the DJI FPV drone, don't do this because it's a dual band. But if you're flying a regular air unit or Vista, get some of these patch antennas or high gain antennas. You'll see a tremendous difference in your signal strength, especially when you do the FCC hack and you can go all the way up to 1200 watts on these goggles. It may not be legal in the US, so check with your local territories to see what's legal or not, but you can definitely take these up to 1200 watts if you really need to. Now, the second thing that I did was, the first set that I got was obviously the DJI set, comes with the DJI remote, but then I decided to upgrade to a actual aircraft remote, such as the RadioMaster TX16. And my buddy helped me kit it out with red. You can get it like this already, or you can get it just standard without the colors. But this is a great remote. And the reason why I say it's a great remote, especially for beginner pilots, is because you get to feel a difference in the gimbals. These gimbals here have full resolution, and it's so different when flying a standard remote. You know, I tested out the new DJI remote, and I've also tested out the regular remote, which I have, the regular DJI remote. And one of the things is that one of the things that I don't like is that the gimbals are too loose. I mean, you're all over the place. Now, when you make these slight adjustments or slight maneuvers while you're flying, that's also translating into your quad in the air, and it's just going all over the place. So if you want, you know, precision, and you want switches to customize to all different flight modes, GPS rescue, beepers, I mean, there's a bunch of things you can do. This is a remote that I strongly recommend for everyone to really look into upgrading from a regular stock DJI remote. Now let's talk about FPV quads. One of the things that I learned when flying FPV is signal does matter, obviously, right? Signal matters with any drone. And one of the things I strongly recommend anyone to do, whether you're building your own FPV quad or you're buying a ready-to-fly quad, is upgrade to Crossfire. This is Crossfire here, that antenna. Crossfire, it will save your behind when you are flying. It's gonna give you the best control. Actually, I've never, knock on wood, have ever lost reception or signal flying with a Crossfire antenna. Crossfire is the equivalent of AccuSync, if you will, if you could compare it to something. I mean, you get rock solid connection with this. Now, moving right along, just to recap, because I'm like all over the place. This is not scripted, I'm just talking as I go. When I think about my journey 6 months back with FPV, number one, I would say key priority before you buy anything is get yourself a remote and get yourself a simulator like Liftoff. You have to practice on a simulator. Practice, practice, practice. Liftoff to me was incredibly helpful. And then when I translated my skills from Liftoff out on the field and flew the real thing, it was extremely close to reality. I mean, I was like, if I was crashing in the simulator and I try to fly in the real, out in the field, I was crashing there as well. If I was doing flips and crashing in the simulator, it was free, it doesn't cost me anything. Now, if I do a flip in real life and I crash, then it's gonna hurt, right? You're gonna break something. But doing tricks, doing maneuvers, doing proximity flights all on a simulator will definitely 100% help you out when you do fly FPV out in the field in real life. The second advice I have is community. You gotta fly FPV with other people that in your community, other people in your neighborhood, people that you have associated with on Facebook. I mean, look at this right here. This is LOS, one of the best groups in New York City to fly drones with. You got some incredible people there who are talented, smart, and helpful, right? You break an arm for the first time, you burn a flight controller, right? You don't know how to solder. Who's gonna help you out? I had a tremendous amount of help initially when I first started. I really wanna thank FPV Mundial, which is a group that started with Alex here locally in New York City. And I followed his FPV journey, and that made me get into FPV. And Alex helped me tremendously. And then Alex introduced me to other people such as Robin, Henry, all these people in this group. There are tremendous pilots who have transformed. I mean, I think about my journey 6 months ago from the summer till now, March, right, of 2021. And I see their journey as well from when they started to now. I mean, these guys are like practically pros, like Mr. Steel kind almost. So it is tremendous. This is a journey and a hobby that you keep learning, you keep progressing, and you become more and more proficient every single battery, every single flight. So it is extremely important that you associate yourself with community. So now I'm just blabbing on too long. I'm gonna go ahead and do some flights today, and it's just gonna be some cruising, not much freestyle going on today. I just wanna practice close proximity within these tree branches and just get some smooth shots. I'll be back in a second. Another best practice or advice I can definitely give you is fly with a GoPro on your quad all the time. The GoPro is gonna do, for me, it does two things. It stabilizes, it gives me a balance, the weight. I like the feel of the weight on the quad. So it kind of gives me like that balanced feeling. I fly with a Hero 9 and also a Hero 8. And then, you know, with FPV, the theme is always you're gonna crash, right? Yesterday I had a slight crash, and look what happened to this GoPro. Let me just turn it on. This is a Hero 9, brand new. Let me show you. Oh, you probably can't see. Let me get closer in. So the screen is done. Screen shattered inside. So internal damage on the screen. The front facing screen still works, right? This is still working. But the back screen is completely done. So, word of advice, if you're buying a GoPro, try to buy it new. Try to buy it straight from GoPro and make sure you get their $50 plan, their $50 insurance plan. It gives you unlimited iCloud storage, and it also prevents or covers, I should say, accidental damage on your GoPros, because this one's gonna go right back to them and they'll send me a new one just for a small fee of like another $50, but it's quite worth it. If I didn't have that, right, it still works, it still records, but I lost my back screen and I'm out $400-$500 for a Hero 9. So that's my advice. Fly with a GoPro and definitely get insurance. Now, my drone journey started with the original Mavic Pro 1, and now I fly a Mavic Pro 2, Mavic 2 Zoom, Phantom 4 V2, Inspire 2, not flexing, but I'm a drone hoarder, if you will. And my journey with drones started with the DJI Mavic series. Fantastic, fantastic drones to have. And if you're a follower of my channel, you'll see that I incorporate regular DJI camera drone footage with my FPV footage. And that's what I wanted to try to do, is combine that cinematic stuff. So I can't wait till the weather gets nicer here in New York City, that it gets warmer so I can hit up spots up north, like Hudson Valley, over in Jersey, go over to Connecticut, Westchester, all that stuff, and hit like those cliffs or mountains, and really go mountain surfing and combine it with FPV with DJI drones. One of the things that I've been loving lately is flying the Mavic and getting hyperlapse for my footage. Wind is definitely picking up, so I hope you guys don't hear that in the audio. However, what FPV has done to my camera drones is that I no longer really use these things. When I fly this, when I take this thing up in the air, I'm getting like, what, 20, 30 minutes? And after 5 minutes, I'm like, oh, what else can I shoot? It's not as immersive as FPV. I don't hate them. I still love these Mavics. I still love camera drones. But once you start FPV, you'll feel the same way I feel. It is an absolute immersive experience. It gives you this sort of adrenaline that these drones will not provide you. So those are just my thoughts on a camera drone versus an FPV. What are your thoughts? Let me know in the comments below. All right, guys, so that's gonna be it. I hope that you enjoyed the video today and my story of how I started with FPV. Again, it's been about 6 to 8 months. The first 2 months was really frustrating, but the experience at the end, when you build your confidence level, when you kind of know what you're doing, when you're able to swap out your own parts, or when you associate yourself with people that are willing to help you, this is an amazing hobby, an amazing experience to get into. Today, you were able to see FPV shots. You were able to see Mavic shots. And you let me know your thoughts of which one were more thrilling, which one did excite you. I know for me, for sure, the FPV shots are more exciting. But let me know, guys, your thoughts in the comment below. Are you going to start FPV? Is DJI FPV going to get you started into this hobby? I think it's a great entry point. Do you see yourself upgrading or buying your own custom build? Let me know your thoughts. And until next time, peace.